Yes, in second part of our video of exercise 1.3, we are going to solve question number 3. Question number 3 is what? If u is equal to 1, 2, 3, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Here u is stand for universal set and p is equal to 1, 3, 7, 10. Then they ask question, so that u, p and p complement by Venn diagram. And question second is what? Verify P complement. Complement of P complement is equal to P. We should verify that complement of P complement is equal to P. Now we should solve first part of the question. What is the first part of the question? So that U, P and P complement by Venn diagram. So first of all, we draw universal set. For universal set, we take a rectangle as a Venn diagram. This is U, and under this we make one circle as a P. This is set P. Now under P, what elements are there? 1, 3, 7, 10. 1, 3, 7, 10. Okay. Now we draw that U is equal to U and P. And after that, we also draw P complement. For P complement, we just see what is left in U after deducting the element of P. 1 is gone, 2 left, 3 is gone, 7 is gone, 8 left, 9, 10 gone, 11 and 12. All this is what? 2, 8, 9, 11, 12. All this is a P complement. So our presentation is completed. U is what? 1, 2, 3, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. P is what? 1, 3, 7, 10. And P complement is what? 2, 8, 9, 11, 12. We represent all three in one diagram. Now second part of the question is what? Verify that complement of P complement is equal to P. We should verify complement of P complement is equal to P. For this, first we see what is P complement. P complement means, P complement is what? 2, 8, 9, 11 and 12. This is P complement. Now we find P complement. Complement of P complement is equal to what? We compare this P complement with U. 2 is there, 1 is not there, 3 is not there, 7 is not there, 10 is not there. P complement is equal to 1, 3, 7, 10, and P also is a 1, 3, 7, 10. Therefore, it is verified. Therefore, it is verified that P complement. Complement of P complement is equal to P. Verified that P complement is equal to P. So our question number 4 is what? A is equal to 1, 3, 2, 7. Write any 3 subsets of A. There are lot of subsets of A. How? Just see. B is equal to 1. We first take single. B is equal to 1. 1 is the subset of A. Yes. C is equal to 3. Yes. C is the subset of A. D is equal to 2. Yes. D is the subset of A. And E is equal to 7. This is also subset of A. After that we take a pair of 2. F is equal to 1, 3. This is also subset of A. G is equal to 3, 2. This is also subsets of A. H is equal to 2, 7. This is also subsets of A. And I is equal to 7, 1. This is also subsets of A. After that, we take a group of 3. J is equal to what? 1, 3, 2. K is equal to what? 3, 2, 7. 3 to 7 and after that L is equal to what? 271. M is equal to what? 713. That is a set of 3. Now M is equal to what? We take all 4 numbers 1, 3, 2, 7. This is also subsets of A. So there are a lot of subsets of A. We write any 3 subsets from this. All this, you took any 3 subsets and write down in exam.
Yes, our question number 5 is what? Write the subsets relation between the sets. This is all the sets. We should show the relation between all the sets. First one is what? P is the set of all resident in Pune. M is the set of all resident in Madhya Pradesh. I is the set of all resident in Indore. B is the subset of all resident in India. H is the subset of all resident in Maharashtra. So first we take Pune. There is a P for Pune. P is a subset of what? P is the city of what? Maharashtra. And Maharashtra is the state of India. Therefore, P is a subset of H and P is a subset of I. Yes. For India, it is a B. P is a subset of Maharashtra. P is a subset of India. After that, we say second one. M is the all the residents in Madhya Pradesh. So Madhya Pradesh is a state of India. Therefore, M is a subset of I. M is the subset of I. The not I, it's a B. M is the subset of B. Therefore, after that, I is the set of all resident in Indore. Indore is a city of Madhya Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh is a state of India. So we already shown that Madhya Pradesh is a subset of India, but we don't show the Indore is a subset of Madhya Pradesh. We show that I is a subset of M. Okay, now we go on third one. We go on third one. Third one is completed. We go on fourth one. B is a subset of V is all the sets of resident in India. India is a universal set. Therefore, it is not a set of any other subset of any other set. Therefore, we go on Maharashtra. Maharashtra is a subset of what? India. Therefore, H is a subset of India. Maharashtra is a subset of India. All this is a subset relation between in this case, all the sets is a subset of what? India. All the sets is a subset of India, that is B. Therefore, B is a universal set for this set. So, question number 6 is what? Which set of number can be universal set for the set given below? First one is what? A is equal to set of multiple of 5. B is equal to set of multiple of 7. C is equal to set of multiple of 12. Now we first write A is equal to what? Set of multiple of 5. 5 1 is 5. 5 2 is 10. 5 3 is 15. 5 4 is 20. 5 10 15 and continue. And B is equal to what? B is equal to what? Set of multiple of 7. 7 1 is 7. 7 2 is 14. 7 3 is 21 and continue. This is also like that. And C is a set of all multiple of 12. 12 1 is 12. 12 2 is 24. 12 3 is 36 and dash. Yes. A is 5 10 15. 5 10 15 come under what? Natural number. 5, 10, 15 is the natural number. 5, 10, 15 is also come under whole number. 5, 10, 15 is also come under integers. Therefore, A is a subset of whole number, natural number and integers. Like that, B is also set of natural number, whole number and integers. And C is also set of whole number, natural number and integers. Therefore, answer for this question is what they ask in question, which set of number can be universal set for the set given below? The answer of this question is all the set of natural number, whole number and integers are universal set for the set given below. I repeat once. All the set of natural number, whole number and integers are universal set for the set given below.
Second part of question number 6 is what? P is a set of multiple of 4.
P is equal to set of multiple of 4. 4 1 is 4, 4 2 is 8, 4 3 is 12. And P is equal to set of all even square number. Even square number, the square of even number is a even. So even square number is what? The square of 2 is a 4. The square of 4 is a 16. The square of 6 is a 36. The square of 8 is a 64. Continue. So like first question, here also 4, 8, 12 is a subsets of natural number, subsets of whole number and subsets of integer, and T is also subsets of natural number, subsets of whole number and subsets of integers. Therefore, set of natural number in whole number and integers are universal set for the set given below.
So last question of this exercise is what? All the student of class are universal set. All the students of class are universal set. Set A is the student who secure 50% or more marks. Set A is the student who secure 50% or more marks in a mathematics. Then write complement of set A. Then we write complement of set A. A complement we should write. First we see what is set A. Set is A is what? A student who secure 50% or more. Then A complement is opposite of that. A complement is equal to a student who does not secure 50% or less. A complement is equal to student who does not secure 50% or less. No, that is what a student who does not name. A student who secure 50% or less.